गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर रीडिंग दिस डी पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर चेंजिंग टाइम, दैट इज ब्रेविंग द ओड्स. हियर देर इज अ स्टोरी ऑफ अ टीचर हु जस्ट डिसाइडेड टू लीव द स्कूल बिकॉज शी वॉज नॉट हैप्पी विद द एनवायरमेंट. शी वॉज नॉट हैप्पी विद द स्ट्रेस शी फेस्ड वाइल टीचिंग. एंड वॉट वॉज दैट स्ट्रेस अबाउट, वी हैव नॉट रेड दैट टिल येट. But she was here, you know, she was talking about the children, that children were always enthusiastic about studies. And after coming from the holidays, it was a pleasure to go back to the school. But now it was not like that. Although she loved her subject and she questioned herself that, you know, it was not only her own failure. It was also the failure of the children. Why? Because, you know, there were so many of the things. She loved her subject and it was not that, you know, it is like a burden to her. But what happened, what was the main reason that why she has decided to get rid of her job? So let's read further. We have read it till here, so we are reading from here. I had been idealistic, but the reality I faced was bored children, overstimulated by video watching the night before, and tired out by late bedtime. So what she was telling about, no, she said that, you know, I had been idealistic. Idealistic, what does it mean? That, you know, she had that ideal picture of those students in her mind, that, you know, that students are always full of energy, enthusiastic, and they were keen and they are curious to learn new things. But here what she found? She found that, you know, but the reality she faced was bored children, that children are very bored today, in today's scenario. They are overstimulated. Stimulated means they have overstimulation, they have over curiosity in them by watching videos the night before, which, and they have used that stimulation for discussing those videos they have watched earlier at night, you know, and they used to watch those videos on YouTube and all those things, and they were all overstimulated by those videos. They are just talking about those videos and stuff they have watched overnight, and they are not even concentrating on their subjects, and tired out by late bedtime. And they all are tired because they used to watch this TV late night and they go to bed late, and that is why they do not have a sufficient sleep, and they always look tired and sleepy all the time. So this was the condition she is facing here. You can look out on those children. They were tired, you know, they are bored, and they were just, you know, talking to each other, you know, they are just talking about those videos which they have seen earlier night, and they are not just, you know, nobody is concentrating on their books and nobody is focusing on the teacher. So that was the scenario she had been confronted nowadays. They were the children who were given the wrong food at wrong time, who came breakfastless to the school. In the school, they stuffed themselves with gum, crepes and sweets brought from the school canteen. They were high with hunger in the lesson before lunchtime and giggled restlessly as the smell of food from the school canteen came wafting to all floors. So what she is saying? She is saying that, you know, they were the children who have given wrong food at the wrong time. It means that, you know, they were the children who are suffering from disorganized timetable, I would say, that they are not provided food, correct food on correct time. For example, they are not eating their breakfast on time, they are not having their lunch and dinner on time. And most of the people, and I think most of you have come, you know, empty stomach to the classes, to the school. You haven't have your breakfast with you, and then you feel hungry all the time, then you really, you know, looking forward for your lunch time. So that is happening with these whole children. They do not have breakfast early in the morning, and they are breakfastless, and they are always, you know, having the attention towards the canteen. And what happened? They are high in hunger. It means that, you know, they were very hungry during the last period before lunch, and their whole concentration is on the lunch, and they were just, you know, that lingering smell. Wafting means that lingering smell, lingering to the floor, that smell of the food which came through the canteen, of the school canteen, and they were just thinking about it. They were just giggling restlessly. Giggling means they were laughing and they were just making noise. They were just thinking about food restlessly in the last period before lunchtime. Okay, so they do not have their full attention on their chapters or on their periods. They were just thinking about food. Why? Because they do not have their food on time, they do not have their breakfast, and that is why they feel hungry all the time, and they do not concentrate on their period all at all. And they were just looking forward for their lunchtime, and they were just, you know, smelling those stuffs which were that smell which were coming from the school canteen. And what do they use to eat? They come breakfastless to the school, and when they what they use? They use gum. They would eat gum, crisp, sweets, or they brought from the canteen of the school, and it was not healthy at all. If they do not eat healthy food, how they would be going to be healthy, and how they would be going to be have a strong health? So that was a problem of this teacher. So there were the children who were constantly testing and belittling each other. Bright, hard-working little girl changed under the pressure of peer group and advertising into assertive, searching, screeching empty heads. Most of them carried makeup in their pencil cases and had a magazine concealed in their desks. So what she is saying further, that you know, these children were those who were constantly testing. So these children, now children have become very annoying. They constantly testing and belittling each other. Constantly testing means, you know, they were always checking each other's patience, always provoking each other, always belittling each other. Belittling means always comparing each with each other, always, you know, making fun of others. This is the thing they used to do nowadays. They used to do that all the time. Bright, hardworking little girls. So bright, hardworking, those hardworking little girls, they have changed. And under the peer pressure, I have discussed peer pressure with you. What does it mean? That, you know, those girls, so intelligent girls, they have also changed themselves under the peer pressure and advertising, mm-hmm. You know, advertising means they have come across, they had the exposure of so many of the things that they really want to have those things around, and they do not have their concentration at all on their studies, you know. And they have asserted screeching empty heads. Screeching means, you know, always just thinking about other things. Screeching, you can say that, you know, disturbed minds, disturbed from the main motive of your life, and the student's main motive is to study. So they have that empty head, which were always full of these all nonsense things, you know, always thinking about peer pressure and all those things. So that what she came across those children. Most of them carried makeup in their pencils. She's talking about those girls that, you know, they used to, now what they used to carry in their pencil box, the makeup things. They used to carry those makeup things with them all the time, and they have those magazines concealed, mean hidden their desk. So they used to do that makeup things in the school, and they used to read those magazines. So there is no such environment in the class so that a teacher can teach the students. The students are not at all interested in their subject. They are overburdened with peer pressure and those all kind of things, so they really do not have any attention towards their studies. Next, then there were the ones from difficult homes, such as Simone, whose parents split up after many years together and who was not wanted by either. His tired eyes flickered all around when I tried to remonstrate with him privately. So what she said, you know, is now giving one more example, that there were the children that comes from difficult homes. Difficult homes mean where there is homes where there is no where the environment is not good, environment is not healthy, you know. And giving an example, that is a boy, Simon, you know, who has come from the home where parents are splitting, they are separated, and no one of the parents wanted him to take him with them. So his mother as well as his father, both of them do not want Simone to take Simone with them, you know. And Simone is very much tired, and his eyes flickered all around. Flickered means his eyes are just, you know, roaming here and there, roaming all around. And whenever that lady tried to remonstrate means try to talk to him, try to resolve his problem, so he's just flickering his eyes. He was just, you know, looking here and there. He's tired because he really do not have any attention in the house. His house is almost broken. His parents are separated, and none of his parents wanted him to be together. So that is the main problem with him. And his pale face never stopped twitching. As his pale is every time twitching. Twitching means, you know, to twitch the movements, the weird movements of face when you are in pain or when you are in very dilemma. So that kind of face he is making. But he could not bring chaos to my lessons with his sniggering and mutterings. But she said that, you know, he could bring chaos. Chaos means disturbance in the class while she is teaching them the lessons. So, you know, he's always not concentrating on the lessons. He's always, you know, sniggering here and there and muttering. Muttering means, you know, talking with somebody here and there, talking with himself also. Sniggering means just sneaking here and there, talking with other friends and talking with other classmates. So he is not at all attentive in the class, and that is a big problem for her. Because she is not having a healthy environment in the class so that she can teach them properly. The rudeness I had to put up with and the bad language appalled me. I had no redress, as the only form of punishment available was a detention, which meant facing the same obstinate lot again. Sometimes parents could be contacted and their help sought, but frequently they were as bewildered and incaptivated as we ourselves. So see what she said, that you know that this rudeness I had to put away. So I have to be rude with those all children again, and you know that bad language appalled me. These children used to have a bad language, and it just surprised her. It just you know amazed her that these very small kids, they are using such a bad language. And she had no redress as the only form of punishment available, and she could not have any other option. She could not have any other option because the one punishment that was the detention. Detention means to suspend those from there, and you know to just put them separate. And she really did not want that thing to be happened to those children. And she was, you know, which meant facing the same obstinate lot again. And she really did not want to them, because they are already, you know, distracted from these all things. If they were detained, they have a detention from their school. So what happened? This is the same thing. They are going to face the same thing again. And she really did not want to do that thing again. Sometimes parents are also contacted. They are also called to class, to student, to schools to help the teachers, but they were also helpless. They were also incapacitated, means it was not in their capacity to help to make those children understand the importance of education and that all thing. So the parents are also feeling helpless at that time. So there is no option with that these children can be pacified. They can be make understood that education is important. So these are the main. This is the chapter. We read it till here. So read this chapter. There are so many of the words here, you know, these difficult words. Find out the meaning for these words. Write them with pencil on your lesson and read it carefully.